You're listening to the Chronicles of Livin podcast, where we talk to everyday people about everyday things in the past, present, and future. Now let's talk. What's going on, my visionary dreamers? This is ADionne, your dream pusher, your lifeguard, saving you from yourself, from the world, from some real bullshit. And you are listening to Chronicles of Livin podcast show, the show for everyday people doing everyday things, living everyday life. You know it's extraordinary, folk, doing a darn thing the best way we can. And I went to the We Buy Black convention by founder Sharif, Abdul Malik. He is the founder, I researched, he is the founder of this event, and it's a wonderful event. It's been going on for a few years, to my knowledge, and I had the pleasure of interviewing some of the vendors and entrepreneurs that were there. Just went, really spur of the moment, just got in town and decided to go, and it was the best decision I made. I met some great people, and so what I'm going to do right now is just play you the conversations that I had with everyone. Pay attention to what these wonderful entrepreneurs have to share with you and to encourage you to do as far as moving into your own dreams and visions in entrepreneurship. So without further ado, I'm going to start the show. What's going on, my visionary dreamers? I'm still here at the We Buy Black convention, and I just ran across this wonderful young man, Naeem, and he is a motivational speaker. And so, guys, you know, visionary dreamers out there, I always tell y'all, you know, get out your own head, stop doubting yourself. And here I'm sitting here talking to this young man, and he is only, first I'm going to let him introduce himself. Tell my listeners your age and what inspired you to do what you're doing. And whatever else you want to tell them, I'm giving you the floor, okay?
Hello, everyone. How are you doing today? My name is Naeem Hudson, but I'm better known as King Nahh. I'm a motivational speaker, spoken at places like, well, I've had the opportunity to speak at places like Africa, Mexico, Dubai, LA. I've been on the Steve Harvey Show, Little Big Shots, Good Morning America, Dr. Oz. And yeah, like you said, I'm a motivational speaker, you know, as a 13-year-old motivational speaker first. I just got to let people know the age. Mm-hmm. Because I hear a lot of people use the excuse, really, of how old they are and what they can and can't accomplish or their limitations. And life, you don't need money. You don't need a big Instagram following. You don't need 10 of millions of people to know you. At first, all you need to start off with is your dream. All you need to start off with is your vision and dedication. Because I never had much when I was starting my brand or my company or even my just business alone. But what I did is I stayed dedicated. I kept posting videos because we all have access to phones. But we don't do the proper things on them. Yes, it's cool to use your Instagram or your Snapchat or play your games on it. But at the same time, you have to make sure you're marketing, make sure some production and productivity is coming from it instead of just the things that you may do every day. It's not going to benefit you. It's going to keep you in the same place that you may not want to be in already. Because who doesn't want to be successful? Who doesn't want to have their own company? Who doesn't want to make generational wealth for their family and their nephews and nieces and their family and family and family and next generation where they're not even going to be here?
Right.
So you have to prepare not just for you, but for those who look up to you. Your family is going to be here when you're gone.
Right, right. Wow, guys. Y'all need to be ashamed of yourself. As he said, he is 13 doing his thing. And I'm not going to curse. I have a saying, but it's a curse word in there, so I'm not going to say. But he is 13 doing his thing. And so tell the listeners, like, what keeps you motivated? I mean, because you're 13, and what helps you to balance out the whole game plan and the things that the 13-year-old wants to do?
I say what balances me out is I know when I have a booking. I know when I have to go to an event, and I know when I have to keep my mind in place. So, yes, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I'm doing homeschool. I'm going to go play basketball. And even people can say that that's not as productive, but it's still productive because I'm still doing something physical with my body pretty much.
Right.
But playing video games, I do that mainly on weekends. But as you can see, the We Buy Black convention was on a weekend.
Right.
At the event day, I barely had my phone out all day. The only time I bring out my phone was to show somebody my website. Because I know when to lock in and stay in tune. Right. And when I'm free, when I'm at home, when I'm chilled, that's when it's time for me to, you know, just let loose and play some Fortnite and just relax.
Right. Y'all hear that? See, balance is everything. When y'all say, okay, you got to work and all of this stuff, balance is everything. So I'm going to just let you tell people where can they find you,
okay?
And then hopefully later on you'll grace us with a video interview, okay? So tell everybody where they can find you.
You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. King Nahh, KingNahh.
What is it that you would like to say to, say, younger people that might be listening your age? Like, what is it that you feel they can do to help them to really get going?
I feel like what you can do to help you get going is really block out all the voices of people telling you what you can't do or what's lame or what's corny. Because as a generation, we look at a lot of things and we judge it first before or after we see it become successful. We want to be a part of it. But really, that's mainly what's going to happen in life. I'm not everybody, but most people. So right. People are going to, they're going to judge, they're going to say whatever, but it doesn't matter. As long as you're trying to generate wealth and you're trying to become successful, that's all that's important, not anybody else's opinion.
Ray, and he has a strong family back, and that's the whole thing too. So, you know, far as how do you stay away from those bad influences?
Just realizing who you are. If you have an identity, then you won't want to have to compromise it to try and make yourself seem similar to somebody else or make yourself seem more appealing to somebody else. You have an identity for a reason. You are you for a reason. You are yourself for a reason. So you shouldn't have to feel a need to copy off somebody else.
Great. Oh, my gosh. I just love this young man. I love his mom and his dad. They did such a great job with him. Is there anything that you want to leave the listeners, my visionary dreamers, with?
Don't let your thoughts and your dreams just be in your imagination. Work hard until the point you can see them in person.
Okay. And tell them again, where can they find you?
You guys can find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube at King Nahh, KingNahh.
Oh, I love it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you.
Okay, guys. I hope that you really, really, really appreciated all of the wonderful people that I had a conversation with at the We Buy Black event. I was just so honored to be able to be in their presence and just gracious that they allowed me to interview them while they were, you know, making money. So please, guys, definitely go and check out their links. Support them. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Share everything that you find out about them. I just pay attention to the bottom of the description. I will have all of their links so that you can get in contact and purchase whatever it is that they have to offer you guys. So without further ado, this was ADionne, your dream pusher, your lifeguard, saving you from yourself, from the world, from some real bullshit. And you are listening to Chronicles of Livin podcast show, the show for everyday people doing everyday things, living everyday life. You know, us extraordinary folk doing the damn thing best way we can. And I just want to thank the vendors, the entrepreneurs again for talking to my visionary dreamers and tuning in to Chronicles of Livin podcast show. Until next Sunday, peace. Thank you for listening to Chronicles of Livin, where we talk to everyday people about everyday things in the past, present, and future. And if you are pursuing your dreams, I'm proud of you, because the best part of life is when you decide to live. To keep up with us, please visit ChroniclesOfLivin.com. Until next time, this is ADionne, your dream pusher. I love you guys.